And we are back. You're listening to Powerful Women Revealed. I'm your host, Nicole Perry. I'm like underlining every single phrase that she's singing in that song. My guest is Susan Walker with Elia Photography, and it's ELIAphotography.com. You know, it's really, we were talking over break about how, you know, we're focused a little bit on the hair, the makeup, the clothes, you know, the wedding dress, whatever you're doing, whatever you're having done. But you're focusing on those things so that you can let the real you come out.
Absolutely. I think those things, it's just kind of like frosting. It's one of those, I think when you look good, when you feel like you look good on the outside, you really let your guard down on the inside, and then what's really there comes through so much greater. I can't explain it. It's a phenomena of some sort.
It is. And you know, she's like, when I look in the mirror and the only one there is me, you know, you got to embrace what God gave you, you know, and I know my creator didn't make no mistakes on me. I love that line.
I do too.
And you really have to embrace with what God gave you.
I agree.
And, you know, don't talk about yourself in a negative way, because a lot of women do that. I don't like my hair. I don't like my lips. I don't like my eyes. I don't like my arms. I don't like this. I don't like that. And, you know, there's a lot of things I don't like.
Sure.
I don't like the acne. I don't like the fingernails that look like I'm 12. But,
right.
You know, I rather focus on all of the other positives. I love my hair. God gave me great hair, and I am happy that I have this good hair.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? I like certain things about me, and we have to do that.
We have to be kinder to ourselves as women, because I think as a culture, I don't know if we're just taught to be unkind to other women, but it's, I think the more we're kind to ourselves, we'll start being kinder to other women, because women need to be collective as a unit, be empowering to each other instead of ripping each other down.
Do you see that still?
Absolutely.
Because I see it.
Absolutely.
I see it out there in the networking world.
Yeah.
That people, and in general, that people are just not as kind as they could be.
I agree. It's not, it's a sad place to be, you know, and I want those women to feel empowered and to love them for who they are and just bring that awesomeness out, you know.
So. Now, how do you work with your clients to bring them out? How do you really get them to open up?
So, well, usually we'll
to 95%. We want them to open up to like 95%, right? Maybe they might not get to be 100, but you really want them to let go.
Sure. I mean, because again, it's a vulnerable thing. It's a trust thing. I don't want to just get a photograph of their face. I want to get whatever's inside that light, that beautiful light of whoever they are to
come
forth.
It's their soul.
Yes. And
it's their spirit.
It's completely. And it's funny when people, you know, in the olden days, they didn't want their photos taken because they thought it would capture their soul or something.
Oh,
wasn't that some sort of urban myth? But a little bit of that is true, because it really stops that moment, and there's something in your eyes that it just lights up.
And a photograph doesn't lie.
It doesn't.
Ooh. So maybe that's why people are reserved.
Sure.
Because they're afraid of the truth that might come out through the photograph.
Yeah.
But who doesn't want the truth?
I do know that when a woman's sitting in front of me, and you can see everything behind her eyes, you can see the vulnerability, you can see what she hates about herself, you can see what she loves about herself, you can see the love she has for her children, it all comes through in that instant, and it's stopped forever. It's just captured there. It's pretty amazing. Yeah.
Well, what do you want to share about photography, about portrait photography versus pinup photography? Something that's a little bit different, but you're still capturing your face and a little bit of your soul. Because we talked about this, that what do you want to share about it? Because there's two different ways to look at it, I guess.
Definitely. I think, you know, with pinup or boudoir, and it's, you know, there are people who do it beautifully, but it's more about the scene of what's happening around. It's more about...
Ah.
Yeah, it's not about...
I think it's about everything. Yeah. It's about the big picture.
Absolutely.
And then when you're doing portrait photography, it's really, you see the person.
Exactly. Because I don't shoot more than 5 or 6 feet away from whoever I'm photographing. So there's a very intimate moment there. And it's less about the beautiful woman and her beautiful body. It's more about that. What's going on inside, if that makes sense.
It's very, very emotional.
Huge.
And it's very spiritual, and it's such a really fantastic experience.
It's amazing. For both, you know, for the person, hopefully. But for me, yeah, exactly.
And so you're pulling the energy. Because you're fun when you're working, because we work together.
Yes.
So you're fun, and you're, you know, laughing and joking,
right.
and you're being the vulnerable one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I didn't think of that.
You're really being very vulnerable as the photographer.
That's interesting. I never thought of it that way.
Because, you know, I was supposed to be mirroring you.
Right, right. Oh, yeah.
Right?
Wow, that's a little epiphany.
All right. Oh, well, now let's talk about real quick. We want to hit a little bit of functional stuff here. Mm-hmm. What is all natural lighting versus fluorescent, and why do you prefer all natural?
Well, it's funny because my mentor calls it God light, and there's really no other light that's better than the sun. I think it's beautiful, and it's very forgiving. I think on everyone, it looks beautiful on everyone. Whereas more of strobe lighting is a little bit different. It's, you can create natural looking light with strobe light, but you're still trying to create natural light. Do you know what I mean? So with very harsh strobe lighting, it looks great if you're a supermodel and you're on the cover of a magazine, because that your body and your face is suited for that.
Mm-hmm.
But I think most women in our position, it's
fluorescent
not,
is no good for me.
No, exactly. And I think that's true for most women.
You know what Joan Rivers said one time? She said, a gray sky day, every woman over the age of 30 needs to go outside today. Like, she's like, when it's gray sky. So do you agree with that? The gray.
It's beautiful, yeah. Overcast days are the best.
Really? Yeah. Oh, my God, that is so funny. All right. Now, what other things or ways do you help exploit the value of each of your clients? Like, how do you help them let go? How do you help them really give what you're asking them to give?
I think a lot of it too, I usually have clients come in before their shoot and we have like a consult. And at that point, I try to just get to know who they are, you know, what their biggest value in life is, whether they have children, whether it's their job, whether it's whatever they love. And I think circling back to that is a big thing, because people love to talk about what they love. You know, if you ask a mom about her kids, she's going to talk about her kids all day, because she loves her kids. And I think it's, and you light up, and those are the things when you talk about something you love, you can't help it. It's just it just comes out. And so I think that is a lot of part of it. I definitely want
pulling
people into that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Well, do we have to go to break? Yes, we do. Okay. I hope you'll stay with us. Susan Walker is my guest, and it's eliaphotography.com, E-L-I-A photography.com. You're listening to Powerful Women Reveal right here on 95.9 WATD.